नमस्कार विद्यार्थ्यांनो, मी श्री हिंगोली SG नेताजी सुभाषचंद्र ज्युनियर कॉलेज ऑफ सायन्स येळगाव तालुका कराड। खरं तर आज संपूर्ण जग कोरोनासारख्या या महामारीला सामोरं जात आहे। त्याचा परिणाम कुठेतरी शैक्षणिक व्यवस्थेवरती, विद्यार्थ्यांच्या अभ्यासावरती होताना दिसतो आहे, आणि मग असा परिणाम कुठेतरी आपल्या विद्यार्थ्यावरती होऊ नये या दृष्टिकोनातून आपल्या रयत शिक्षण संस्थेनं काही उपक्रम हाती घेतलेले आहेत, आणि त्या उपक्रमाअंतर्गत आपल्या विद्यार्थ्यानं घरात बसून अभ्यास केला पाहिजे, अर्थात तो शिकला पाहिजे, तो या व्यवस्थेत टिकला पाहिजे, याच एका विचारानं आपल्या संस्थेनं हे उपक्रम हाती घेतलेले आहेत। त्यापैकी एक उपक्रम म्हणजे हा रोज उपक्रम। या उपक्रमाअंतर्गत आपण 11वी या इयत्तेमधील काही जे काय विषय आहे त्या विषयांतर्गत जे चॅप्टर्स आहेत त्या चॅप्टर्सचे रिव्हिजन आणि टेस्ट अशा अभ्यासणार आहोत। आणि मग हे अभ्यासत असताना मी आज जो आपल्यासमोर येत आहे ते रोज बायोलॉजी या विषयांतर्गत मी आज तुम्हाला एक चॅप्टर रिवाइज करणार आहे, त्याच्यातील काही भाग रिवाइज करणार आहे। तो चॅप्टर आहे चॅप्टर नंबर 14, ह्युमन न्यूट्रिशन। ॲक्च्युली ह्युमन न्यूट्रिशन मानवाच्या शरीराचं पोषण हे कसं होतं हे ह्या चॅप्टरमध्ये आपण शिकणार आहोत। ॲक्च्युली शिकलो आहे त्याचं काही रिवाइज्ड भाग आपण पाहणार। जनरली व्हेरी फर्स्टली वी नो अबाउट दी इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस चॅप्टर। इन दिस इंट्रोडक्शन वी नो अबाउट दी व्हॉट इज मेड बाय न्यूट्रियंट्स। सो दी एनिमल मेक यूज ऑफ केमिकल सबस्टन्सेस कॉल्ड एज दी न्यूट्रियंट्स। सो दिस केमिकल सबस्टन्सेस व्हिच आर इनटेकिंग इन द बॉडी ऑफ दिस एनिमल हॅव टू हार्वेस्ट द एनर्जी फॉर ग्रोथ ऑफ द बॉडी, provide protection from different diseases to the body. Then the nutrient have to provide energy for repairing of tissue and gamete production. So this chemical substance which is intaking by the person, and this there means the substance are nothing but the nutrients. Actually these nutrients becomes derived by the human being by means of the specific process, and this process is nothing but the nutrition. So what is meant by nutrition? The nutrition is the sum total of all the processes through which food is taken in, digested, absorbed and utilized, or undigested food substances are eliminated out is called as the nutrition. That means the particular processes which are included in the process of the nutrition, and these processes are the ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and very finally egestion. So the one more definition which is also made by means of the WHO means World Health Organization. Actually WHO is established in 1945 in Geneva. So according to WHO, the nutrition is the intake of food considered in relation to the body's dietary needs. That means human body have been required the specific diet. Actually this diet have been consist of the specific biomolecules. These biomolecules may be macrobiomolecules and the microbiomolecules. Macrobiomolecules includes carbohydrates, proteins, fats, and the microbiomolecules includes vitamins, minerals, water, fibers in adequate amount. So such material, such biomolecules intaking by the requirement of our body or the dietary need, and this that means the process is nothing but the nutrition. So actually in this nutrition, there are five that in the steps are present. The first step is ingestion. That means the process in which food is taken inside the body. Then this food, which is digested by means of the next step, that means the digestion. So, what is meant by digestion? The process during which the complex, non-diffusible and non-absorbable food are converted into simple, diffusible and absorbable form by enzymes are known as the digestion. Then digested food is absorbed. This is the next step. Absorption of simple substances takes place in blood by simple diffusion. Then the next step is the assimilation, the process by which protoplasm is synthesized into each cell of body by utilizing simple food called as assimilation. And the next one is the digestion. So the digestion is the removal of undigested food substances outside body through anus. And this process is known as the digestion, or maybe defecation. So collectively we study about the what is meant by nutrients, what is meant by nutrition, and the steps of the nutrition. Then we have turned toward the next part of this chapter, and this part is the human digestive system. Actually, the human digestive system consists of two major components, and these components are alimentary canal and the digestive glands. So the alimentary canal is the first component, which is very essential in the digestive system of the human being. This alimentary canal is a long tubular structure starting from mouth and ending by means of the anus. So this particular alimentary canal is a very long structure, that means 8 to 10 meter, and it consists of the different organs, and these organs may be mouth. So this is the mouth. Actually the mouth, it is small cleft opening, clipped or the opening present on face region. It is about also called as oral or the buccal cavity. It is bounded by fleshy lips. Okay. It's that means the side walls are formed by cheeks. Roof is formed by palate, and floor formed by the tongue. It is internally lined by means of mucous membrane, comma, salivary glands are open into buccal cavity. So the internal, our mouth becomes consist of the specific organs, and these organs may be the teeth, tongue, or maybe internal lined by means of the mucous membrane, and also our mouth having the cavity, buccal cavity, consist of the opening of salivary glands. So the mouth present on the face region is very important because it performs the specific functions, and these functions may be ingestion, mixing food in saliva. Then the tongue present in mouth have to detect the taste, and the teeth present in mouth have to masticate the food. So our mouth is then internally open into the buccal cavity, and itself consists of the specific organ as the teeth. So we have learned about the teeth. So our mouth have been consist of such type of the two jaws, and internally these jaws becomes larger by means of the specific organ, and this organ is nothing but the teeth. So the study of teeth with respect to their number, arrangement, development is known as the dentition. In human adult, the 32 teeth are present in buccal cavity. Human dentition is described as thicodont, then diaphyodont and heterodont. सो दी थिकोडोंट मीन्स वॉट, सो ईच टूथ इज फिक्स्ड, ओके, सो ईच टूथ इज फिक्स्ड इन सेपरेट सॉकेट प्रेजेंट इन जॉ बोन बाय गॉम्फोसिस टाइप ऑफ द जॉइंट देन डायफायडोन. सो इन ह्यूमन बीइंग इन आवर लाइफ टाइम we get only two sets of teeth, that is milk teeth and the permanent teeth, and that's why the specific, that means the phenomena which is present in the human being is the diphyodont. Next, the heterodont. So the type of the teeth present in the human beings are heterodont because we have four different types of teeth, and hence our type of the teeth becomes heterodonts. Which type of teeth? So in human being, the incisors, canines, premolars and the molar. So these four types of the teeth by means of its different shape sides present in human buccal cavity. That's why the teeth are heterodont. Actually, these heterodonts present in the human being have been consist of like this. So, the number of the teeth present on a single jaw, by means of the half of the single jaw, becomes like this. Actually, half of the jaw. So, this is the half. Here, the first half of the jaw consists of the two incisors, one canine, three premolars, and the two molars. That is, 8 teeth becomes present on half of the jaw. They have been different in shape and the size. And this may be incisors, canines, premolars, and the molars. So actually, this teeth number is 8. And the second half of the jaw becomes 8. So collectively, each jaw consists of the 16 teeth. And 16 teeth present on the single jaw, human being, two jaws are present, actually upper and the lower. Upper jaw having the 16 teeth, lower jaw having the 16 teeth. That's why 16 plus 16, 32 teeth are present in the adult human. And the dental formula of this teeth is 2-1-2-3, 2-1-2-3. That means equistivis, equistivis. Actually, two incisors, one canine, two premolars and three molars. So these are arrangement of the teeth present on the jaw of the human being. Actually, we have studied the structure of the single tooth. So the tooth consists of the portion that project above the gum. So the gum which is present here and the portion which is present above the gum, this portion is called as the crown, and itself this crown becomes alveages, that is the embedded into the gum, no doubt, and the very hardest substance which is covered it on the crown is known as the enamel. Okay, so the crown itself have been consist of the covering substance known as the enamel, and this enamel is a very hardest substance. Actually, this crown is made by means of the calcified tissue. Basically, this tissue becomes made by means of the calcium phosphate, the calcium carbonate, and internally our tooth becomes consist of the cavity, and this cavity is known as the pulp cavity. Actually, the pulp cavity contains the pulp which is connected to tissue with blood vessels and nerves. Pulp cavity extends in the root of the tooth called as root canal. Here, so this is the root canal, and the cementum substance which is, that means the surround the particular, that means the root canal here, cementing substance. So this tooth in the socket of the jawbone fixed with the cementing substance. So totally this interstructure of the tooth is like this. One more organ which is again present into the mouth of the human being is the tongue. It is muscular, then the fleshy, roughly triangular in shape. It is lies along the floor, then the lower jaw, having the floor of the buccal cavity. The upper surface of the tongue bears numerous projections, this surface. And these numerous projections have been known as the papillates. The papillates may be filiform, fusiform, fungiform. And always between them, the sensory some receptors are present, having the taste buds. And the taste buds present between the papillates have to detect the taste of the food which is intaken by the person or the human. So, our tongue have been constructed the different sides or the positions. Actually, tip of the tongue have to detect the sweet and the salty taste. The lateral side of the tongue have to detect savory taste, and the posterior part of the tongue detect the bitter taste. So the tongue is the one of the organ which is present in the buccal cavity. It's very important because they have to detect the taste of the food. Then this buccal cavity, which is then open into the, so the buccal cavity which is open into the next, that means the part of the digestive system, and this part is the pharynx. Actually pharynx, the buccal cavity leads to a short pharynx. Pharynx is a common passage for food and the air. The upper region of the pharynx open into trachea through an opening known as the glottis. Always this glottis is guarded by means of the cartilaginous flap called as epiglottis. Okay, so the mouth, then the opening, and actually this, that means the opening becomes open into the pharynx, and the pharynx itself have been consist of the trachea as a nasopharynx opening, and which is always guarded by means of the epiglottis. So the epiglottis encloses during or closes during the swelling of action and prevent entry of food into the trachea or the respiratory tract. The epiglottis guarded on the glottis is very important because they have to prevent the entry of food into the trachea or the respiratory tract. Then the lower region of the pharynx is called as oropharynx, and oropharynx opens always into the esophagus. So this is the esophagus. So it is thin muscular tube. It lies behind the trachea. It measures about 25 cm, passes through the neck, central aspect of rib cage, pierces the diaphragm and joins the stomach. So this enjoys the stomach. It is lined by mucous cells. Histologically, esophagus is made up of longitudinal circular muscles. The rhythmic wave of contraction and relaxation of these muscles is called peristalsis. Okay, so the next, this esophagus is enter into the next part of the digestive tract. And this part is stomach. So this stomach is located in, so this is the stomach. Stomach is located in the upper cleft or the upper left portion of the abdominal cavity. It is a muscular sac like J-shaped organ. The length is about 25 to 30 centimeter length. And it is divided into upper cardiac region and lower pyloric region. So this is the stomach. So the stomach itself consists of the upper, that means this is the cardiac region and this is the pyloric region. Between them the body is present and fundus part is present. सो कार्डियक रिजन इट इज फर्स्ट पार्ट इन विच इसोफेगस ओपन. सो द इसोफेगस इज ओपन इन टू द कार्डियक रिजन. द कार्डिया सराउंड्स द बैंड्स ऑफ सर्कुलर मसल्स एट द जंक्शन ऑफ इसोफेगस एंड स्टमक कॉल्ड कार्डियक स्फिंक्टर्स. हियर हियर द कार्डियक स्फिंक्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट. द कार्डियक स्फिंक्टर्स प्रिवेंट अ बैक फ्लो ऑफ फूड फ्रॉम स्टमक टू द इसोफेगस. सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. कार्डियक स्फिंक्टर्स प्रेजेंट बिटवीन देम. नेक्स्ट वन is the fundus. Here it is the dome shaped region above the left cardiac side of the stomach. Then the body, so this is the body, it forms the large central portion of stomach dash 24. And the last one is the pyloric stomach. It is a narrow posterior region of stomach. It opens into duodenum. It opens into duodenum. Okay, and this opening is guarded by again seat of sphincter muscles known as the pyloric sphincters. So this pyloric sphincters have to regulate again flow of food from stomach to the duodenum. Actually the stomach is the temporary stores the food and gives the feeling of satiety. That means the satiety means feeling of fullness. And in the stomach, the food is churned and help in mixing the food with gastric juice. The next part of the digestive system is below the stomach, small intestine. Actually, in human being, it is longest part of alimentary canal, about 6 meter in length and 2.5 centimeter in width. It is highly coiled, okay, highly coiled. So the stomach is that means the small intestine is highly coiled, supported by means of the mesenteries and the blood vessels or the lymph vessels and the nerves. Again, the small intestine is divided by means of the three regions. These are the duodenum, then the jejunum, and the last is the ileum. Okay, so the duodenum is proximal part of the intestine. It is U-shaped, about 25 centimeter long. The common bile duct from liver and pancreatic duct from the pancreas open into the duodenum. Here, okay, here. Then the jejunum, it is about 2.5 meter long. It is middle part of intestine. It is narrower than the duodenum. Then the next part of the stomach is the ileum, and it is the last part of the intestine, about 3.5 meter long. The digestion and the absorption of food mainly occur in the ileum. Mucosa landed by Peyer's patches in the intestine. It is also known as the intestinal tonsils. And the very last part of the digestive system is the large intestine. So this is the large intestine. Actually, large intestine itself is the shortest and the wider tube divisible into three regions. It is about 1.5 meter long. The regions are cecum, then the colon, and last one is the rectum. So cecum is the small blind sac present at the junction of ileum and the colon here. Okay, so it is 6 centimeter length. It hosts some symbiotic microorganisms. An elongated worm like vermiform appendix arises from the cecum here. Appendix is vestigial organ in human being and functional in herbivorous animals, gavat khanare prani. So in herbivorous animal, this appendix is functional for the digestion of cellulose. The next part of the large intestine is colon. So the cecum open into colon. Colon is tube-like organ, consists of three parts. These parts are ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon. And the descending, that means the colon, always enter into the pelvic region. That's why it is known as the pelvic colon. And the pelvic region colon continues into last part of the large intestine known as the rectum. Here the rectum is the last part of alimentary canal. Its wall is distensible, hence it acts as a storage organ for fecal matter, vista. It opens outside through the small opening known as the anus. And the last, that the opening of the alimentary canal is the anus. So the anus is the open outside by the body of the alimentary canal, having always guarded by means of the sphincters. And this anus is used to remove undigested material and extra material, unuseful material outside by the process known as the defecation or egestion. So collectively or the totally, we have studied the digestive system of the human being, and in this, that means the particular topic, we have studied about the nutrients, steps of nutrition. Human digestive system consists of the particular component. First is alimentary canal, another digestive glands. Actually, alimentary canal constitute the mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, and the anus. Then the diagrammatic representation of this digestive system of the human being. Then the tongue, then the teeth, arrangement of the teeth, number of the teeth, dental formula of the teeth, then the internal structure of the tooth. Then the stomach, a very important part of the alimentary canal. And the total, the alimentary canal of the human being. So we have discussed the next, that means the part of this topic, in the next lecture. Thank you.